The Navajo, or Dine as they prefer to be called, are a tribe from the southwest, located in the Four Corners area of Utah, Colorado, Arizona, and New Mexico. The Navajo reservation is the largest in the U.S. The reservation consists of over 140,000 people and covers 16 million acres, which is about the size of West Virginia. As is the case with nearly all of the indigenous people of North America, the Navajos have experienced a long and unfair battle with the U.S. government. After being kicked off their land in 1850, the Navajos were allowed to return in 1868, where they played influential roles in World War II as code talkers. The Japanese could not decipher the Navajo language, therefore giving the U.S. a huge advantage. With the return to assimilation, as a result of the 1953 termination resolution, Native Americans were forced to step backward in their fight for equality. At around that same time, the U.S. government began extracting uranium from the Navajo reservation around the Carrizo Mountain area, which is located around Shiprock, New Mexico. Uranium mining had been occurring in that area for some time, but with the start of the Cold War, the demand for uranium skyrocketed due to its use in the making of nuclear weapons. Because the mines were on Navajo land, the mining companies recruited the Navajos to mine. However, the mining companies did not mention that uranium could be deadly to humans exposed to it for extended periods of time. Along with the cancerous effects of exposure to uranium, Navajo miners also faced dangerous mining conditions and extremely low wages. Because of the scarcity of jobs in the 1950s, many Navajos had no choice but to work in the mines. Ironically, Navajo culture tells us that uranium should never leave the ground. Pledge, as they refer to it, would become a serpent and bring bad things among the people if released from the ground. How right they turned out to be. Uranium has continued to be mined in Arizona since the Cold War, and for a while nothing was done about the safety of the Navajo Indians. Finally, in 1990, the Radiation Exposure Compensation Act was passed to provide financial support for the families and victims of radiation exposure. Navajo miners or their widows were supposed to receive awards of $100,000 each. However, because they were Native American, widows of deceased miners were unable to provide official marriage licenses to authorities. It took 9 years for provisions to be made to help Navajos receive their awards. This cultural snafu is an example of how some minorities are overlooked when it comes to compensation for past acts. Despite these attempts by the government to compensate for past radioactive contamination, uranium mining continues on Navajo land, despite repeated spills and leaks that contaminate the water and soil on the Navajo reservation. In fact, the largest radioactive spill in U.S. history occurred at Church Rock, New Mexico, located on Navajo land, in 1976. This spill unleashed 93 million gallons of radioactive water into the Puerto Rico River. After years of having their concerns about health and contamination fall on deaf ears, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, finally took some action in 2009. They developed a plan to clean up the mess around each mine, but they decided to store the radioactive waste into disposable containers on Navajo land. The reasoning? Moving waste to a licensed site in Utah would be too expensive, according to the EPA. However, the EPA had no concerns transporting uranium over Navajo lands in the 1970s and 80s, once again highlighting the fact that indigenous people are often overlooked and treated unfairly in regard to governmental regulations and policies. The uranium mining had a major impact on Navajo houses or hogans. The Navajo used rocks and dirt from the reservation to build their homes. Because of the repeated leaks and radiation exposure from mining, these rocks and the dirt were contaminated. The unsuspecting Indians lived in these radioactive homes for years, unaware of the deadly toxins they were breathing. As part of the EPA's proposal, contaminated hogans were removed and rebuilt. However, many Navajos were rightfully angry that they had been kept in the dark for so long. Despite the current efforts to clean up the Navajo reservation, the road to recovery is long. We don't know how many Navajo lives uranium mining has affected. The only thing known is it has to be stopped now.